everybody, welcome back to my channel. Salut les amis, bienvenue et bonjour sur ma chaîne. Hola, bienvenue à mi canal. Konnichiwa, watashi no channel ni yokoso. I hope you're doing fine today. This is another day, another week, and another video of me. Today we're gonna talk about personal style. Last week I had my video on how to be able to always shop on a budget. It's gonna be somewhere here, just definitely take a look at it before even getting to this video. Be prepared from that video. It's the first step before even going to any store. So today we're gonna dive deep into it. Main steps when it comes to it. Having your personal style, having to define your personal style, it's never really easy. I created a cheat sheet that I'm gonna put down below for you. It's gonna be a roadmap for visually see what your style is and how you can improve it or just add up even more to it. Before even getting to that, definitely subscribe. I love fashion. I love sharing advice when it comes to fashion. I'm a personal stylist and of course I read it, something that I really enjoy doing, not only for me but for people that I get to help through building the confidence, claim the power back when it comes to style in general and really create their own lives through the personal style. If it's your vibe, definitely subscribe to it, hit the bell button so that you can get notified every single time I get to have really nice styling tips like this video. Everything is gonna be down below, just subscribe, you know. So when it comes to defining your personal style, we have a lot of roadblocks when it comes to it. Why? Because we live in a society where there are norms. I agree with norms, I think we all need it, but I don't want to say that I don't live by society norms, no, like no. But I think when it comes to my style, I kind of owning more and more because at the end of the day, I have that different style and some people are gonna like it, some people are gonna hate it. Some people are gonna approach me thanks to it and some others are probably gonna be repelled by it. And it's okay because it's gonna help you to find your tribe, to find your people and to find anybody you really want to attract, not people you don't want to attract. That's gonna be a tool for you to really focus on people that are gonna be interested in you. When you define your personal style, you're not only choosing your clothes, but you're choosing your life. Appearance does matter. Even more importantly, because we have a lot of creative women building their personal brands, having that kind of empowerment. Nowadays, we have a lot of competition. To be able to have to make a difference, to be able to have a mindful wardrobe, not only you're gonna be able to make a difference between getting to more clients, but you're gonna be able to build a life according to you. When you're gonna go to a meeting, when you're gonna go to a date, you're gonna crush it. The first step here is to explore and research. Many of us, we don't know our style because we've been exposed to just a few ideas. Go further, go deeper than just looking at fashion magazines. Your environment, place where you live, what you like the most, even when it comes to the food. I'm gonna take me as an example. I love music. You might wonder how the music can be related to my style. Well, I grew up listening to a bunch of different style of music. I listen to African music most of the time. I then started to listen to French music because I grew up with that as well. I was 9 when I really started to be so passionate about Asian languages, Japan, South Korea. Because of it, I really developed a style where it was definitely edgy because I got to mix match so many genres. Because of the Asian music that I was listening to all of the time, I kind of developed my style around and based on multiple styles. That's how I grew up. Then became a part of me. Really good, and I definitely think you should take your inspiration in there and really pick everything that you really like and really resonate to you in a more emotional way. Everything around you is a part of you because it's your environment. Think your background as being your fashion inspiration. Your mom, your dad, your siblings, your friends. See wherever and whatever resonates to you the most. Further than that, any fashion magazines, blog, just a few parts of everything that can inspire you. I love drawing, I love arts in general. My way of connecting to people, to make it such in the art form so people can relate to it or people can connect to it more and kind of see how I'm feeling. So style is a form of art, the purest form of art to me. It's gonna be your form of art because you're gonna appropriate it. The second step here is to collect. Once you've done your research, you explore everything, it's time to collect everything. And most of you, if not all of you, using Pinterest already, you want to create a mood board, a visual board for you. Really great way to help yourself with anything that you're gonna like. Any celebrity site, what's the easiest part about Pinterest is that you can just type either the name, the celebrity name, or just a certain style, or just a certain piece that you're looking for, and you're gonna find so many more inspiration based on all these keywords. Go up to 30 pictures, for example. Just be sure that it's not like hundreds and hundreds, because you're not gonna be able to get to the next step. What is the thing that really you like the most into that outfit? Is it patterns that you like the most? Is it the shape of it? Is it the cut of it? Is it the length of it? Is it because it's much more classic? Is it because it's more romantic, feminine, bohemian? The way you feel when you look at it, write it down. When you're collecting these pictures, you're gonna start to focus yourself in a certain type of pattern, pieces, colors, a style. What is it about that outfit that just resonates to you that much, and why it's such on a repeating mode? It's gonna be your roadmap here. All of that is a part of you, so write that down. It's really important for the next step. So let me know if you want a video on that, where I could describe in each video every style and the key pieces or where you can shop them. The next step here is gonna be to go back to your closet and take a hard look at everything you already own. Crucial step here, if you want to evolve your style or to make some improvement. Sometimes we have this one or two pieces that sometimes just stick out of the whole style story from your closet. Could be a kimono. It's gonna be so much more different of your other pieces. They're gonna be much more classic, for example. The reason why you pick that, we tend to buy pieces that could be so much more different from our style because we want to give it a try, but you're not sure, you aren't feeling so much more comfortable for a lot of reasons, because you are scared of being judged, are way too much for you. But you need to ask yourself why. Sometimes you wear something that maybe your friends are not used to see on you, you're gonna react a certain way, not necessarily the way you want, but just a certain way. And you can be scared of that. You can be feeling really overwhelmed and be like, oh my God, I'm not gonna be able to pull it off. Heard so much similar stories from my clients. Sometimes we are afraid to own it. As we're evolving, pieces you had before are not gonna be the pieces that you're gonna keep wearing. Instead of just throwing it away, give it a try. See what you can do with it, because it could be the piece that could be inspirational for you to build up something around it. There's a couple of options here. So one of the options that I'm gonna share with you today is style it with a signature item you know you're gonna be feeling comfortable in. You know that kind of piece that everybody is giving you compliments about? Wear it. Wear it with it. You're really feeling good in. It could be a t-shirt, it could be a certain pair of jeans. Try to find a way of combining something you like and you love, you adore, and you know you're gonna receive compliments with something you're not too sure about because it's not necessarily your style yet. What represents the biggest or majority of your style? You have to experiment. There's not any prescription when it comes to style, right? As a personal stylist, I can make mistakes as well. It's gonna be a total fail. Okay, you have to be okay with it. Guys, most importantly, have fun with it. Honestly, it doesn't have to be so serious. It doesn't have to be that deep, but it's gonna be a tool for you to be able to evolve in your life. If you don't experiment, you'll never know what's gonna fit you the best when it comes to your own personal style. You have to feel. If you don't feel it, it's not for you. Sometimes the first could be a fail, but the more you're gonna try it, the more you're gonna kind of grow into it. Your style will evolve with your own story, your situation, your background, your environment. If you change environment, that's gonna be another change for you, because living in Canada and living in a country in Africa, for example, it's never gonna be the same. The weather is not the same. And not only that, but it's gonna be a certain way of seeing life or seeing things in general. No matter what you do, it's gonna affect you. Style is not a black a white thing, but be okay with evolving. Whatever I'm gonna say to you today, maybe in a couple of years from now on, I'm gonna see my videos and there's gonna be a difference. And it's the same thing for me. Back then, when I was going through my gothic phases, when I was going through my kawaii or gyaru phases, I just kept all of these pieces, not wearing them anymore the same way that I used to wear them back then a couple of years ago. And another phase, another chapter of my life, learning is all about learning new things, but it's all about you being open to learn all these new things. Life happens, so we have to make any outfit count here, right? But you have to be able to attract the right people for you. That's all about defining your personal style. Refine it, embrace it, fight for it because it's you, it's your story. Claim it, own it. I'm too passionate. I'm too passionate when it comes to it. I hope you liked it. I hope you adored it. If it was useful for you and more about any type of style really and key pieces related to each style, you can create a series on it. I would be really happy to do it actually. And don't forget to check out my cheat sheet down below. It's gonna be a really great roadmap for you how to claim it. Nobody else will do it for you. Check my last videos. They're all gonna be related to styling hacks, but most importantly, how to be able to shop on a budget and any inspiration when it comes to it. On Thursday, I'm gonna have another haul for summer. A couple of pieces that I was able to pick, so subscribe if you haven't yet. Hit that bell button because you're gonna be able to be notified every single time a video comes up. I'm gonna see you for my next video, and like I say all the time, smile because it's free and contagious. Bye.